Hi, welcome to Wolf the Aviator gliding channel. Today we are at Skelling Farm, home of Eden Soaring Gliding Club. Being on holiday at Lake District, I couldn't resist to visit this club and perhaps have a go. I was lucky that day. Richard Maskell, very experienced pilot from Cambridge Gliding Club, wrote his duo discus and did his side check just before my flight. It was my turn to fly K-13, but I asked if I can fly with him. He agreed, so I jumped into backseat, strapped in, and we took off. I wasn't expecting anything more than ridge soaring that day, but when we managed to climb above the ridge, we found there are other gliders higher and more upwind than we are. It was rather possible that they made it with ridge lift, so we expected there must be a wave we can get into. Richard turned into wind, and indeed we climbed and climbed and climbed. We managed to reach about 9,000 feet, which was enough to get to another wave bar into wind, and then reach Kesik at Lake District. Please watch it yourself. If you enjoyed this video, share it, leave a comment and subscribe for more. For pictures from this flight, check out my Facebook page.
Okay, I won't do much talking until we're established.
That's all right.
Because, as I say, I haven't flown here much.
Focus on flying.
Glider 2 o'clock,
yeah,
high.
Let's go over there.
Another one, also high, 2 o'clock.
Those two.
Yeah. I'm gonna report the traffic, if you don't mind.
No, I'd be delighted if you report traffic.
Good. Glider 9 o'clock above us.
Southbound, right hand 20.
Carter, Senator.
Further upwind. Yeah.
Deal, isn't it?
I'm happy to share photos and videos with you.
Thank you.
Oh, another glider.
Yes.
It's real close.
Golf Charlie.
4 knots almost. For a while. From this point, it looks like full cover ahead of us. No. I lost track of those two gliders
they're
a while ago.
Below,
yeah.
So I thought I'd just, if this will go up to 10 or 12,000 feet, then why not? Because there's a lot of cloud cover, isn't it?
Yeah.
We also need to work out the geography of what might be causing the lift. What the orientation of the wave system is. So not utterly, I think it's westerly, a westerly wave system or northwest.
There should be slight nodal component today.
Yeah. But it's generally, you know, there's no point setting off.
We're still above the clap.
Let's get our bearings. We are flying. We are on a track. Are we tracking 206?
Where am I saying? 212.
We're heading northwest at the moment. Penrith is over there. Appleby's down there. And the lakes are there. So that slot there. Over there must be either, I'm not sure that's way, but that's some kind of chance. So we are now heading north. Oldswater is due that way. Trying to work out what that slot's for. See, there's a slot over there.
Yeah.
Not whether that's a wave slot or whether that's just a pile of shite, as we call it.
I can't tell.
No, I can't either. So at the moment we're heading. We've got Penrith. We'll be down there somewhere. And Oldswater is probably just down there.
Melbourne. So yeah. Penrith should be on 11. Left or from us, I guess.
Right.
Then it should be left from us. 9 o'clock, 11, maybe from over there.
What should be down there?
Penrith?
Penrith is just down there. I've got I've got a moving map. Penrith is just under the nose, so.
We're heading towards Melbury, and I know that Penrith is left, but from that high, yes, that's very close to us.
Sunset is down there. Must be, what time sunset? 6:30?
At, you know, 21st of September, it should be around 6 o'clock Zulu, right? So it's
7 o'clock, yeah.
Yeah, it's around 7 the night.
That does look good there, I'll give you that.
You don't want to push further? You know,
I want to have a little look around here first, so maybe I may be making a mistake, in which case we can drop back there.
I would stick to your plan.
If it doesn't work, it doesn't work.
I have 1,000, that's...
Well, five should, and a half, so...
Yeah, we are well above any obstacles. Okay, we pierce through. Okay. So according to your theory, we should be in lift soon.
Yes, in a few seconds.
Let's see. You got more sync now.
Yeah, if you're not in lift, then I apologize.
No, that's all right. I think we still should go further upwind.
If this doesn't work, then we go back, but this looks reasonable, doesn't it?
Okay, we've got less sync now than before.
Sure.
2 knots, okay. Yeah, it's getting better. Yes, we are in almost. Zero.
One point 7 knots. 2 knots.
We're heading to track with 222.
Yep.
Which is 50 degrees south of the west is over there.
Yeah.
So we're heading at the moment. We're heading south. We're
Roger, message. And quickly from sunset.
Lots of sync will be going back.
Okay. No, I didn't say anything. Yeah.
Very clearly defined from here, isn't it?
Yeah. Well,
this is better back there, isn't it? Better back the other side of Oldswater. We have a wave edge here anywhere, isn't it?
Yeah.
There's one back there.
You know,
that's working well back there.
Yeah. That's what I want to mention.
Yeah. But we're going to be in CG units.
Yeah. A66 below us.
Is it?
Yeah, it leads from Keswick to Penwick.
Over this lot in the past.
What time is it now?
6 o'clock.
6 o'clock. Because between 3 and 5, there could be low-level jets flying over here.
Okay.
Here and there.
We hit the series. Well, the fact that 8 down is quite a good sign.
Remember Tango?
Yes.
When we get across here.
Exactly.
Around, hit the ground.
Fantastic.
Remember Tango, go.
You enjoying yourself back there?
Oh yes, fantastic views.
You're not minding me doing the fly?
No, absolutely. You know, I learn a lot anyway.
Yes. Well, that was the deal. But I think you've done quite well out of it, to be honest. I think it's a good fly.
Yep.
And it's very nice having the company and somebody taking the photo.
Oh yeah.
Jesus, we've got this stuff, haven't we?
Five,
we have got this nailed.
Fantastic. What's your average, sir?
What's the average,
yeah?
Five.
Fair enough.
5.5.
Yeah. Good.
Even soaring, anybody on the ground? 7.2.
Yeah. Finally, we managed to get a really strong lead. Yeah.
Well, I did say we might go over to the lake. very pleasant, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was. And not that difficult.
Sorry?
And not that difficult.
No. We can tell everybody else it wasn't difficult.
Yeah.
About 6.5, 6, 7.
Above the ground?
Yeah.
Perhaps. Almost 7,000 above the scaly.
We got down to about 4.5 down there, didn't we?
Yeah.
I'm quite tempted to go back and land.
Are you?
Well,
let's do it then.
Just on the basis that I'd like to land there with a good light the first time. And we've probably got another 30, but we're not, I don't think we're going to get much higher, are we?
Probably not.
We've been to 8.5. The only thing we could do is have one little belt along this wave bar here, over the lake.
Okay.
Then go back. Getting 5.72, anybody on the ground gets stuck there.
5.5, 5.5, 5.5, 5.5, 5.5, 5.5, 5.5, 5.5, 5.5, 5.5, 5.5, 5.5, 5.5, 5.5, 5.5, 5.5, 5.5, 5.5, 5.5, 5.5, 5.5, 5.5, 5.5, 5.5, 5.5, 5.5, 5.5, 5.5, 5.5, 5.5, 5.5, 5.5, 5.5, 5.5, 5.5, 5.5, 5.5, 5.5, 5.5, 5.5, 5.5, 5.5, 5.5, 5.5, 5.5, 5.5, 5.5, 5.5, 5.5, 5.5, 5.5, 5.5, 5.5, 5.5, 5.5, 5.5, 5.5, 5.5, 5.5, 5.5, 5.5, 5.5, 5.5, 5.5, 5.5, 5.5, 5.5, 5.5, 5.5, 5.5, 5.5, 5.5, 5.5, 5.5, 5.5, 5.5
have plenty of margin. For another hour, I'd be going. Let's do some ridge soaring somewhere.
well, at least I know how to get away from the ridge.
We've been flying 2 hours, 7 minutes.
Good.
What a disaster is it? The wall front.
Ooh. 5 kilometers.
10 kilometers, 5,500 feet. We might just make it.
Nine kilometers. It's going very quickly.
Oh, we're doing that. The vis is very bad into summer. You can see Oldswater there.
Yeah.
Flick the switches. We have a green light. We have a green light. Ignition on. Bit of speed.
We've got power.
Not yet.
Thank you.
reasons, I normally run the thing before going anywhere with it. That's it. Undercarriage is locked. We are now 1,200 feet. What's the runway directions here? I can't remember. 3-2, is it?
Something like that. 3-2. Looks a bit flat,
yeah.
At the moment. I hope that gap is bigger than 20 meters.